grootste gedeelte van de speech zal ik in het Engels doen vanwege buitenlandse gasten, maar ook vanwege veteranen die deze uitzending ook nog kunnen bekijken. 76 years ago, the skies above Eden filled with hundreds of paratroopers. The local people looked up, hopefully, were they finally going to be liberated after so many dark years of occupation. The date was the 18th of September, 1944. For the second day in a row, the drone of aircraft was heard in the sky. Another endless stream of airplanes flew over and hundreds of paratroopers jumped from them. Drop Zone Y was the target the 18th September. It was Schinkelheath in Ede, the place where we are now. Nearly 2,000 young men were preparing to take a leap into the unknown that day. Imagine what it must have been like for those mostly very young men sitting in the plane and waiting. The tension, the drone of the engines, and the howling of the wind. There was a delay due to fog. They woke up that morning in a relatively peaceful England. But that day they had to fight for their lives in the occupied Netherlands. They sat together on the plane, chatted, and maybe smoked a cigarette or quietly prayed. Then it was time. The Heath, Schinkelheath, came into sight. They parachuted down to liberate us from the occupiers. But as some 2,000 men jumped from the plane, they were met by a completely unexpected inferno of bullets, smoke and fire. Among these men was the 33-year-old lieutenant Yves Acquard, the only Frenchman among the English soldiers. He too jumped out of the skies above our Heath on that day. But what was he doing here? Yves Acquard had been fighting for freedom from the start of the war. He had just completed his military service in Algeria when it started the war and was ready to serve again. He was recalled to duty in 1939 and he was assigned of the Premier Regiment de Chasseurs Parachutistes in Algeria, where he was wounded in battle in 1942. While he was recovering in the hospital, he met Major Sir Richard de Bacancourt d'Avaux, a British officer of the 1st British Parachute Battalion, and they became friends. In 1942-43, Acquard arrived in England to continue the war from there. His friendship with the British Major got him assigned to the 1st Air Infantry Battalion in Camberley. He then transferred to the Intelligence Service, where he was following trainings to become a secret agent. But instead, he was transferred to the 1st Airborne Division, the battalion led by his British friend. He jumped from a plane above here on the 18th of September, 1944. But came under deadly fire and died before he touched down on Dutch soil, where he lay lifeless on the heath. As a tribute to this Frenchman and his story, this year the French tricolore and joined the other flags here. And today the delegation of the French embassy will lay a wreath in his honor, Yves Acquard. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, on behalf of the municipality of Ede, I would like to welcome you to this special commemoration and to this special place. Dames en heren, jongens en meisjes, van harte welkom. Hier, 76 jaar geleden, landden 2000 paratroopers. Onder hen was een jonge Fransman. Hij was gewond geraakt in Algerije, had kennis gemaakt daar met Britse officieren, en sprong als enige Fransman tussen alle Engelsen, sprong hij mee. En voor hij de grond raakte, werd hij getroffen door vijandelijk vuur. Daarom hangt dit, deze dag, hangt ook de Franse vlag hier tussen de andere geallieerde vlaggen. I am proud we can commemorate in freedom. But this year is different than those what we did before. The coronavirus dominates our daily life, and it is the reason we can only be here with a few today. And no parachutes can jump from the sky, but the greatest loss is the absence of the veterans, the warriors of the time. We miss them all. I sincerely hope that despite their advanced age, they can be here next year. In previous years, they sat right here behind me. Today, they are proudly represented by young paratroopers, men and women who today are still committed to peace, security, and freedom in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, 76 years ago, the battle was fierce. Memorials and historical accounts help us to reflect on what happened that time. There are so many stories. They evoke so much grief and hold such important lessons for us. They teach us that evil begins with prejudice and humiliation, dat geweld begint met boosheid en met vernedering en met voorrechten en met oordelen en vooroordelen. The yellow star for the Jews, or Jewish children who cannot allow to be attacked at school, and many others from whom there was no place in Nazi Germany. But they also teach us that there is friendship, vriendschap, friendship between the men who made the parachute jump here, friendship between countries, nationalities that are also represented here today and that continue to fight to cooperate in wars taking place all over the world. We must listen carefully to the stories of the past. We moeten altijd luisteren naar de verhalen uit het verleden. Each year we come to this place to recall the stories of the young men who dared to make the jump. And we will continue to do so. We will shortly hold 1 minute silence. If you listen carefully, you can hear their stories. They provoked the silence and the rustling of the leaves. Countless stories and memories we hope to pass on here today this morning. Let us learn from them and deploy them as weapons against injustice and tyranny. Let us learn from them, I recall, and deploy them as weapons against injustice and tyranny. Laten we leren van het verhaal van vroeger, maar ook van nu, wanneer er conflicten zijn. En dat het onrechtvaardigheid is en tyrannie, laten we daar vandaag aan denken, want het is er nog elke dag in de wereld. Today we bow to the many victims who fell here, to the battle they fought, and to the survivors who sadly cannot be here with us today. We bow to those who fell for our homeland and to those who risked their lives to save others. This year we celebrate 75 years of freedom, the freedom to make our own choices, de vrijheid om onze eigen keuzes te maken, wat komt toe niet, and to commemorate, contemplate and experience together. Lest we forget, laten we niet vergeten.
I'm sure that everyone watching this service will take the time to appreciate and remember the sacrifices that were made in Holland 76 years ago. It is so important that it is never forgotten. Finally, let us hope and pray for a return to normality by September 2021. Thank you. Utrinque gratis, ad unum omnes.
Dear attendees, for this special occasion, I would like to take you back into the past. It is Tuesday, September 19, 1944. Captain Quiripel has landed on the heath in front of us as part of Hackett's 4th Brigade yesterday. On its way to the bridge in Arnhem, the brigade encounters enemy resistance at several points along the route. In the vicinity of Hotel de Leer en Doedel, the 10th Battalion runs into the so-called Steel Wall, where the enemy has his troops and armored vehicles well organized and lined up at the Dreyingseweg. In a desperate effort to reach the bridge, Captain Quiripel loses many of his men. As the enemy forces them back to the west towards Wolfhazen, it becomes clear that Lieutenant Colonel John Frost and his troops at the bridge will have to cope without reinforcements. The high embankment of the railroad turns out to be a major obstacle in keeping contact with the units south of it. The railroad crossing at Wolfhazen is soon lost to the enemy, and thus the units of the 10th Battalion get trapped between the advancing enemy from the north and the railroad embankment in the south.
Good morning, everybody. Firstly, I want to bring you greetings from the Royal Army Chaplain's Department and from our Airborne Brigade, 16 Air Assault, based in Colchester, England. It is truly an honour to be with you here today. I'm sure that you are all aware that Army Chaplains accompanied the troops here in 1944. We have done so for centuries, and we will always do so. In 2016, I had the privilege of meeting one of the Arnhem chaplains who had landed on this very site. The Reverend Bill Phillips arrived by parachute with his men on Sunday the 17th of September. He then went on to minister to his men as best as he could in the midst of the battle, and eventually found his way to a St. Elizabeth Hospital along with the regimental doctor. Whilst caring for the wounded, Bill was unaware that at some point the hospital was overrun by the enemy, and on Tuesday the 19th he became a prisoner of war.
Dank aan de gevallen. Ik dank je. Dank met heel mijn hart. Om je verbroken leven dat jij hebt overtuigd. Om mij te kunnen geven. Toekomst, verleden, heden. To the fallen ones, I thank you. Thank you with all of my heart for your broken life that you sacrificed to be able to give to me, future, past, present.
Followed by 1 minute of silence and the reveille signal.
Jump! Three, shoot!
Als organisator van deze herdenking en omdat de landingen op de tweede dag van de slag hier hebben plaatsgevonden, wil ik nu een kans leggen door de burgemeester en wethouders van de gemeente Ede. Burgemeester Verhulst, samen met de wethouders mevrouw Veldman, de heer Meijer, de heer Pater, de heer Oefsloot, de heer Van der Schans en de gemeentesecretaris de heer Groen, leggen een krans. due to the fact that this ceremony is organized by the municipality of Haven and the landings on the second day of the battle took place at this location, the next reef will be laid by the mayor and aldermen of the municipality of Haven. Mayor Verhulst, together with the aldermen Mrs. Velman, Mr. Meijer, Mr. De Pater, Mr. Roeslot, Mr. Van Schans, and the town clerk, Mr. Blue Groen de Leijerief. Een belangrijke rol heeft bij het organiseren van de diverse activiteiten rondom het herdenken van de operatie Market Garden, zal de commandant, de brigade-generaal Smits, nu een kans leggen namens de commandant der strijdkrachten. 11th Aerosol Brigade is a full partner during the planning and execution of various activities in order to keep the memory alive and also hosts the exercise Falcon Leap. The commanding officer of the 11th Brigade will now lay a wreath on behalf of the commander of the Dutch Armed Forces. Vooral bestuurd door Amerikaanse manningsleden. Daarom zal nu zijn excellentie de heer Piet Hoekstra, ambassadeur van de Verenigde Staten van Amerika, nu een kans hebben. Besides the deployment of airborne soldiers in Nijmegen en Eindhoven, at this location the transport aircraft were mainly flown by American aircrew. Therefore, His Excellency Mr. Piet Hoekstra, the U.S. Ambassador to the Netherlands, will now lay a wreath. Namens de Poolse bevolking zal nu de ambassadeur van Polen in Nederland, zijn excellentie meneer Marcin Czepelak, een krans leggen. As part of the Allied Ground Forces, the main force of the proud 1st Independent Polish Parachute Brigade landed in the vicinity of Bril, under command of Brigade General Sasabowski. The Dutch government awarded the Polish soldiers with the highest military medal for their efforts during Market Garden, the Militaire Willemsorde. On behalf of the Polish people, His Excellency Mr. Marcin Czepelak, the Polish ambassador to the Netherlands, will now lay a wreath. Binnen de geallieerde strijdkrachten. Grote delen van Nederland, waaronder de gemeente Ede, zijn uiteindelijk bevrijd door de dappere Canadezen. Namens de Canadese bevolking zal nu de ambassadeur van Canada in Nederland, haar excellentie mevrouw Lisa Helfand, een krans leggen. Canada was an important partner within the Allied Forces. Big parts of the Netherlands, including these surroundings, were, in the end, liberated by the brave Canadian soldiers. On behalf of the Canadian people, Her Excellency Mrs. Lisa Helfand, the Canadian ambassador to the Netherlands, will now lay a wreath. Ook vele Australiërs brachten binnen de geallieerde grond- en luchtstrijdkrachten het hoogste offer voor onze vrijheid. Namens de Australische bevolking zal nu de ambassadeur van Australië in Nederland, zijn excellentie meneer Matthew Neuhaus, een krans leggen. Many Australians brought in the other drowned and air forces the highest sacrifice for our freedom. On behalf of the Australian people, His Excellency Mr. Matthew Neuhaus, the Australian Ambassador to the Netherlands, will now lay a wreath. Van de onfortuinlijke Franse deelnemer aan de operatie, de luitenant Yves A.K. Ter ere van onder andere zijn offer zal nu meneer Laurent Sicillon namens de Franse ambassadeur een krans leggen. Mayor Verhulst told us the story of the unfortunate French participant of the Operation Market Garden, Lieutenant Yves A.K. On behalf of a grateful nation, Mr. Laurent Sicillon, representing the French ambassador, will now lay his wreath. Als waardering vanuit de provincie en de overige bij de slag op Arnhem betrokken gemeentes zullen nu de plaatsvervangend commissaris van de Koning, de heer Trent, samen met de burgemeesters van Arnhem, de heer Marcouch, en de burgemeesters van Renkum en Overbetuwe, mevrouw Schaap en mevrouw Wojtink-Rauwbos een krans leggen. Out of gratitude from the local other authorities, the next wreath will be laid by the representative of the Commissioner of the King, Mr. Trent, together with the Mayor of Arnhem, Mr. Marcouch, and the Mayors of Renkum and Overbetuwe, Mrs. Schaap and Mrs. Wojtink-Rauwbos. Zal nu een krans worden gelegd door de nabestaanden voormalig verzet, de heer en mevrouw Thomassen. On behalf of the Dutch resistance fighters, a wreath will be laid by the offspring of the former resistance force, Mr. and Mrs. Thomassen. De krans wordt namens de Stichting Airborne Herdenkingen gelegd door de heer Van der Laan. The final wreath will be laid on behalf of the Foundation Airborne Commemorations by Mr. Van der Laan. I will now invite the future to the stand in order to play their important part in this ceremony. Beste kinderen, willen jullie gaan staan? En mag ik jullie vragen om naar voren te komen? Dames en heren, als dankbaarheid voor de gebrachte offers brengt onze toekomst een bloemengroet bij het monument. Kinderburgemeester Lisa en de kinderwethouders Nora en Max en Rijn gaan zo dadelijk bloemen leggen, samen met hun broertje. Jullie mogen nu bloemen neerleggen. Voordat we officieel gaan afsluiten, zal Harmonie Ede samen met de Pegasus Spikes and Drums nu samen met het Highland Cathedral voor ons spelen. Before we officially end the ceremony, Harmonie Ede, together with the Pegasus Spikes and Drums, will now play Highland Cathedral for us. In de tussentijd zullen de parachutisten voor ons naar beneden komen en achter u op de heide gaan landen. In the meanwhile, while we enjoy the music, paratroopers will come down to elaborate the ceremony. Excellenties, dames en heren, we sluiten deze ceremonie af met de sprong van het Nederlandse militaire vrije valteam. De majoor Koen Kersbergen zal uit waardering voor alle veteranen de vlag met het symbool van de Britse 1e Luchtlandingsdivisie, de Pegasus, voeren. Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, we end this ceremony with the deployment of the Dutch Military Freefall Team. In honor of all veterans, Mayor Koen Kersbergen will show the Pegasus flag during his descent. On behalf of the organization, I would like to request you to maintain social distance and not all leave at once. You are free to enjoy the weather and the lunch inside the airborne aide bag at your present location, or walk along the monument, and we wish you a safe trip home and hope to see you again next year under different circumstances. Ik verzoek u om afstand te bewaren en niet allemaal tegelijk te vertrekken en bijvoorbeeld gefaseerd langs het monument te wandelen of hier bij de borden die langs de heide staan lunch uit het airborne edetasje te nuttigen. Op de borden langs de heide zijn beelden te zien van toen in vergelijking met missies van nu met prachtige foto's van 11 Vluchtmobiele Brigade. Namens de burgemeester van de gemeente Ede, meneer Verhulst, en de commandant van 11 Vluchtmobiele Brigade, generaal Smits, dank ik u hartelijk voor uw aanwezigheid en respect tijdens deze ceremonie. We wensen u een veilige thuisreis en hopen u volgend jaar, hopelijk in betere omstandigheden, hier terug te zien. Dank u wel.